other little devils making a historic comeback, with 90% of Tasmanian devils wiped out due to disease and sadly with no sign of slowing down. The Devil Comeback Program is the wild plan to help boost the numbers of our native animals.
8.25 kilos. So she's gone up a little bit. Hopefully that means Joey's. We've got two Joeys in here. They're about the size of a large mouse, probably 2 months old, just starting to get their fur.
Wow. To fill us in is Tyler Gralton from Aussie Ark, who joins us live from Barrington Tops in New South Wales. Tyler, welcome to the show. Absolutely amazing work that you guys are doing. The Devil Comeback Program has just celebrated its second anniversary. Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, good morning, Sarah and Tristan. Thank you for having me. We have just reached a really exciting milestone for us up here at Aussie Ark, this second anniversary of getting these Tasmanian devils back into the wild. So they were found all across mainland Australia as recently as 3,000 years ago. So for them to be back where they belong in a native habitat with no feral animals is a really big milestone for us. And it's 2 years of breeding seasons that these individuals have been out there, which means we're starting to see what happens when you put wild devils back in the wild.
Oh, that's such exciting news. Hey, Tyler, before the breeding programming, what were Tasmanian devil numbers like on the mainland? They were pretty low, right?
They were quite sporadic. So Tasmanian devils and their ancestors were found in many different habitats across mainland Australia. The only reason you only find them in Tasmania now is because their role in the ecosystem was kind of overtaken by the dingo once that was introduced across mainland Australia. The dingo serves a really, really important role as a natural predator, but the Tasmanian devil as a scavenger, there just wasn't much left for them to find on the ground. So the only place you find Tasmanian devils is where you don't find dingoes, and that's on Tasmania.
Wow, that's it. I've often heard Eric Bana talk about the Tasmanian devils as well. Now, with this one, Chris Hemsworth and Elsa Pataki, they helped with the initial release of the devils on the mainland. That must have been pretty special to get people like that on board.
Oh, certainly. To have the God of Thunder release Tasmanian devils is kind of a match made in Asgard, if you will. And having his partner Elsa up here as well was absolutely fantastic. So to have these high-profile individuals take such an interest in the work that we do here about getting Australia back the way it should be is crucial to the program. And it's just really nice to see that these superstars that seem bigger than life, what we're doing is interesting them enough to come up here and help us release Tasmanian devils.
Now, Tyler, can we see a devil behind you now, behind you to your right, I believe?
Yeah, certainly. Up there, I can see Dwight running around on the log. Even down at the base of the log there, I believe Jerry is having a sniff too. So I'm currently standing in a Tasmanian devil right now. So if anyone comes to visit Aussie Ark, this is what they see. This is everything that a visitor gets to see whenever they come to Aussie Ark.
Oh,
fantastic. That's
what love your excitement and your passion as well, Tyler. Thanks for standing in the rain as well to tell us all about the Devil Comeback Program. What a great thing you're doing. AussieArk.org.au is a place to go. Give them a follow. Thanks again, Tyler.
Thank you so much, Sarah and Tristan.